So it is obvious that one is an important direction is a connection between the novel problems that are important all over the world and the education, because it is obvious that ignorance in these spheres lead to the negative results, and the, in general the progress in different directions of economy, politics, development of industry finally lead unfortunately to the negative results. So that's why it is a rise up a very comprehensive problem. First of all, the successful development of novel approaches in industry simultaneously with the successful decision of the problems of the environment protection and widespread of novel languages in education in order to create a normal understanding of the tendencies in all over the world. So we develop a new approach based on the combining of such directions, scientific directions, such as teaching of Akademician Vernadsky about the biosphere, thermodynamics, microbiology, chemistry, analytical chemistry, biochemistry, ecology, biotechnology, and industry. And due to the combining of these approaches, we created a novel direction, so-called thermodynamic prediction of interaction of microorganisms with different ways. So the main idea of this approach to obtain the successful detoxification, fermentation of all kinds of organic and inorganic compounds, but not only to detoxificate, but also to obtain the valuable products from all kinds of these waste. And here you can see several stages of applying to this problem on the base of the thermodynamic prediction. First of all, due to the anaerobic hydrogen fermentation, one can obtain several suitable products. First of all, molecular hydrogen. It is, and after applying fuel cell, it is possible to obtain the electricity from the molecular hydrogen. The next suitable product is solid fuel. It means dry, non-fermented rest after fermentation. And additionally, after aerobic fermentation, it is possible to obtain the very effective biofertilizer on the base of this non-fermented dry rest. The second step is fermentation and degradation of soluble organic compounds, such as range of alcohols and organic acids, with obtaining three profitable products, such as methane. It is food quality carbon dioxide and pure. Due to the consideration of a biochemical reaction in coordinates of pH and redox potential, pH it is abscess and coordinate it is a redox potential. The end result is the understanding that only minus 400 millivolts at natural condition are suitable for the methane fermentation and hydrogen fermentation also. And on the base of this consideration, we obtain the biotechnology, in extreme condition, in Antarctic station, at the mission Vernadsky. One can see that only after 5 days of fermentation, the mass decrease was in 80 times. And here you can see, you can compare the initial waste and final your waste after only 5 days of fermentation. And also it was confirmed in semi-industrial testing. Here you can compare the effectiveness of industry indexes in real industrial biotechnologies and our indexes. So we obtain the decrease of time retention, it means the time of fermentation, more than 10 times. Then we increase the effectiveness of degradation more than 8 times, and hydrogen yield was increased also in 2 times. Finally, we obtain several positive effects. First of all, the strong decrease of waste mass and obtaining of two kinds of energy. Molecular hydrogen, that means the ecological pure energy carriers, and solid fuel. The biohydrogen obtained during fermentation is completely possible to burn on the outlet of gas cooker. Here you can see the process of burning of biohydrogen and applying of copper wire for the oxidation, almost more or less a flame of biohydrogen. And this picture confirms the effectiveness of dry non-fermented resides as an example of the solid fuel. But after additional aerobic fermentation, it is possible to obtain the biofertilizers that consist of not only suitable for the plant's organic matter, but also the high content of soil microorganisms, nitrogen fixation, nitrogen fixation bacteria, and producing of ammonia. And finally, our biotechnology was adopted for the small farmers' cottages, villages, and here you can see the possibility of fermentation of mixed waste, such as fecal grain and solid waste, and in automatic control bioreactor. It is possible to obtain four suitable products. First of all, clean water for irrigation, for cutting irrigation, then solid fuel and biofertilizer. And on the right picture, you can see the result of applying for this biofertilizer, the good yield of a range. The problem of degradation of organic waste in the dumps is very important all over the world. And unfortunately, rarely in dumps during near 30 years, the volume of solid organic waste decreased only in 2 times. But due to the adaptation of our biotechnology for these processes, we obtained very effective biodegradation of this waste. Only during 2 weeks, the mass decrease was in 20 times. And what is very important, the end products of this biodegradation, it was a test mixture of methane and molecular hydrogen. And this yield was very large, 40 liters of this gas mixture from each kilogram of solid waste. And eruption for the precipitation of chromo 6 soluble compounds. And for the discovering metal resistant microorganisms, we provide the bioprospectin in extreme ecosystem on the cliffs of the Dead Sea, in Ecuador, in mountain jungles, in cliffs in Antarctica, in karst caves, and in Ukraine, in the zones of the shelving. And the result of this theoretical and simultaneously practical investigation was the creation of novel combined biotechnology. Here you can see that during the simultaneous fermentation of decaying potato and reduction of soluble chromate, we obtain several positive effects. First of all, solid waste utilization, then hydrogen synthesis, drain purification from chromate, obtaining the concentrate of chromate hydroxide and final purified water. And the possibilities of microorganism in the consideration of the practical clients are almost without limit, because you can see that a microorganism can start and reduce the chromates at the very high concentration, 1,000 ppm of chromo 6. And it is obvious that this condition considered as incompatible with the life. But it is not the end of the perspective of obtaining valuable products from the waste. After drying the microbial biomass covered by chromo-3 hydroxide, we can burn this biomass together with chromase precipitate and obtain the crystalline form of chromo-3 oxide. And due to this operation, we obtain binary positive effect. First of all, the decrease of anti-mass of secondary waste, and finally, we obtain the co-circular products, crystalline of chromo-3 oxide with abrasive properties. So it can be applied for polishing or cutting of the stones. One of the headaches of environmental protection direction is the controlling and degradation of so-called xenobiotics. It means the synthetic organic compounds that are completely aligned for the whole organism or ecosystem. And on the example of nitrochlorobenzene, very toxic compound, we confirmed the effectiveness of approach of our thermodynamic prediction for the detoxification. One can see that the high toxicity of this nitrochlorobenzene based on the simultaneous presence of three toxic factors, nitrogen and the chlorine organic groups and toxic aromatic compounds ring simultaneously. And on the base of a reductive pathway of degradation, it means the using of nitrochlorobenzene as an artificial acceptor of electrons, we obtain the complete degradation, reductive degradation of this toxic compound with obtaining non-toxic final products such as ions of chlorine and ammonium and carbon dioxide. Conclusion. More than 400 years ago, well-known philosophist and scientist Francis Bacon proclaimed there are neither theoretical nor applied sciences. There is only application of science to practice. So, on the basis of this fundamental philosophic approach, we developed the universal biotechnology that gives the possibility to effective degradation and detoxification of a wide range of toxic compounds and obtaining of range of suitable products of them. But it is obviously that this direction is very complicated and based on the different knowledge from the mathematics, biology, ecology, chemistry, and so on. And it is very difficult task to inform the society, inform the students, PhD, and so on, businessmen for the successful implementation. So to popularize this approach, we use, first of all, internet. We have on our own site a collection of scientific